Hello, my name is Harry Munns, and I am the Deputy Chief and Director of Operations for the Chula Vista Fire Department. Fire Safety Week 2020 is here and is an opportunity for us to engage with you about fire safety awareness. Fire Safety Week is observed every year in October, and it is in commemoration of the Great Chicago Fire, which began on October 8, 1871. More than 250 people died, with over 100,000 left homeless. This historic event initiated the longest-running public health and safety observance on record. Our goal right now is to inform and educate everyone on fire safety awareness and ultimately reduce injuries or death due to fires. Because of the COVID-19 pandemic, we are unable to engage the public like we have in the past with the open house event where we can share fire safety information and provide tours of fire stations and fire engines. For now, we still want to engage with you virtually and therefore have put together a series of videos taking you on tours of Chula Vista fire stations in the city, followed by important fire safety tips. Here is your Chula Vista Fire Department.
My name is Christian Puebla. I work for the Chula Vista Fire Department. Welcome to Station 5, 391 Oxford Street, located in Southwest Chula Vista. Originally, this station was known as the Montgomery Fire Protection District, and it was built in 1959. It was then annexed in 1986 to Chula Vista Fire Department. Come take a tour. So we'll start with the app bay. This is where we keep our engine. It's a single engine house, meaning that there's only one apparatus here. There's a double house that's also known. A double house is known as a station that has an engine and a truck there, but this is a single engine house to me, so we only have one engine here. We also have our extra hose here and a bunch of other random tools that we use to keep our station up to par. So this is our backup hose. Whenever we do go to a fire, we take this hose and we take the dirty hose off that and replace it. And this is our washing station for our hose. So once we come and use our dirty hose, we come out to the hose rack, we come here, brush it off, clean it off, dry it off, and then we put it back on the rack, ready for the next fire. Here you also have our EMS cabinet. So when we run low stock on the engine, we always come here and replenish it. We can't restock from other resources. And if we don't have it here, then we just put in a requisition order through the department and they bring us more equipment. And here, like I said, we have more random tools, miscellaneous tools, kind of keep our station clean and tidy as possible. It's a bit of an older station, so it's kind of hard to do, but we get it done as best we can. So we wash the apparatus every Saturday. And in here is where we have our washing equipment. So we have our wax, drying towels, tire shine, a bunch of stuff to make the engine look as nice as possible. And you can see up here on the back side, you can see the 55, and it's also located on the back of the engine. It means 55 for Spanish. One thing I want to show you guys, kind of this compartment, we do get a lot of fires in the river bottom. So we're pretty well versed with this compartment. It's all our wildland hose. Granted, they're not as big as the ones that you see on TV where they're thousands of acres, but we do go down there and use our wildland equipment quite often. Through this door here, it takes you to the day room area. It's a four-person house, so we have four recliners here. This is where we come and kind of wind down after dinner, after a busy day. Get a few moments of rest before you go to bed. Back here, we also have another storage closet with all our cleaning supplies and all our equipment. Extra gloves, mops, a bunch of stuff that you would find in your regular home to keep it clean. And here's just one of the restrooms that we have at the station. And back here you see, these are what's called our strike team bags. So when people get sent out to the large wildland fires, they're gone for up to 2 weeks at a time. And this takes all your creature comforts, extra clothes, anything you're gonna need, basic necessities that you would need to be gone for 2 weeks. And going through this door, it'll take you to our parking area. So this is our parking area, and it will also take you to our washer and our drying machine. So big difference between these two, This washer and this dryer is used mainly for our station clothes, clothes that we wear on a regular basis. And this is used, you can see here on the label, for turnouts, for our PPE, our personal protective equipment that we use on fires. Big thing with that is we don't want to cross-contaminate and throw our turnouts in here, because we don't want to get all the carcinogens on our good clothes. That's a cancer-causing agent that they found through years of research. So we keep that separate. We wash this in here, and we don't throw them in the dryer. We let them air dry. Back here, we have another closet with cleaning materials, cleaning supplies. Going through this door, this will take you to the sleeping area, our sleeping bunks. It's a bit of a smaller station, so we don't have bunks per se. We just have, we don't have rooms per se or dorms. We just have our sleeping bunks. This is my here, so a bit close quarters. In here, you have another restroom. And this here is the captain's quarters on this side. It's his bunk. This is my locker. I have a bunch of hygiene materials, extra uniform stuff, extra clothes, my computer. Going through here, you have another restroom. Come in here, you have the kitchen, and you also have the captain's desk where he does all his paperwork. This is where we sit down and have dinner every night, breakfast, lunch. And this is where we have all our cooking utensils here. Similar to your home, anything that you would need to cook. We have forks, knives, pots, pans, all kinds of stuff. Cups, plates, bowls. And we also have our three fridge here, A shift, B fridge, and C fridge. And walking through this door, it'll take you back into the apparatus bay. And you make a left here, it'll take you through our turnout storage. So we have two sets of turnouts. This is our backup set. The one that we use on the engine is our front line. And when those get dirty, we switch them out and wash them. And we just rotate as we go. So this is where everybody keeps their turnout storage, their extra turnouts. Keep walking through the door. You have more turnout storage right there in the back. And this is our gym area. So this is where we get a good workout in the morning, provided we're not on a busy day. So sometimes we don't get the opportunity to work out. We're at a busy station. But when we do, this is when we come and get our exercise in. This back here is our, I guess you could call it our cardio room. We have an elliptical and our treadmill. And back there is just more personal storage stuff. So guys bring all their study materials when they want to get ready for a test that the department is putting on. And we come take our study materials and study in here in the firefighter's office. Thank you again for visiting Station 5, but before you go, we want to leave you with a little tip. Whenever you're doing your grilling and your barbecuing outdoors, make sure you're at least 3 feet away from your house or any sort of bush or shrub that could potentially cause a fire. Again, thank you for visiting Station 5, and we'll see you around.